I'm here.
Oh, can I kiss you?
Yuck. Hi.
I'll get out my tears now. You look beautiful. The dress.
Yeah. Did it work?
Yeah.
You look so handsome. The tie is perfect. See, it matches
it. It does. Yep. It does. I know, finally.
It's so overwhelming.
Totally. Oh, you should be out here. I got paparazzi all over.
I love you.
ladies and gentlemen, would you stand for Shawna? This is a day that has been made to celebrate two lives that will be joined together as husband and wife. We who have come together this evening to witness this wonderful and historic day for Shawna and Ernie will now surround them with our love and share in their joy on this day. Who presents Shawna to be married to Ernie?
Her family and I.
Thank you. Your bouquet for a little bit. You can hold it for a little bit if you want. You may be seated, and good evening. I'm beginning with a reading from Isaiah 54, partially because it fits these two so perfectly. The mountains may crumble, the hills may be shaken, but my love for you will never leave you. And my covenant of peace with you will never end. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. And in the spirit of those words, Ernie and Shawna, in celebration of their love, has now chosen this time to honor their relationship by formally uniting as husband and wife. And it's truly my honor to be here for them on this celebration of their love. As we begin this ceremony, we will honor some individuals who are no longer with us. Ernie and Shawna wanted to take just a moment to honor the memory of Shawna's dad, Tom, whom she loved very much. Ernie is honoring his grandparents, Amelia and Jerry, and Julio and Isabel. And while they cannot be here in mind and body, I'm sure they're here in spirit, and their blessings overlies this marriage and this wedding very much. We got lucky with the rain. It's an absolutely gorgeous afternoon. I don't know about anybody else down front. Thankfully, it just got about 8 degrees warmer with the entrance of this most gorgeous, beautiful Shawna. Am I right? How about that, Ernie? By the way, you look very sharp too. I'd like to see a show of hands. How many are here just to see that it's really Ernie Paez up here at last getting married? We can all feel the love up here in this space today, and I know that you are a close-knit group of family friends who've gotten yourselves here, and some traveling further than others to be here, and it's so obvious what these two mean to you. In fact, I know that they believe that their marriage would be somehow not quite complete without the presence, support of family and friends. So I want you to know how much we rejoice in your presence. And speaking of family, I really can't go any further without recognizing this lovely maid of honor, Shawna's daughter, Kaylin, is right here, right? And I know it's an honor for mom to have her up here standing. And he's not a blood relative, but he practically could be. Best man Henry, since 4 years old, has known her. How about that? So you see, everything was painstakingly put together by these two because of how much and what they think of you guys. So please know that your love, your encouragement, will always be required by these two. And I know how much they will appreciate it. So to all of you, I say, may you be as important to them always as you are this day. Marriage is a commitment to life, to the best that two people can find and bring out in each other. It offers opportunities for sharing and growth that no other human relations can quite equal. It's a joining that is promised for a lifetime. Marriage understands and forgives the mistakes that life is unable to avoid. It encourages new experiences and new ways of expressing a love that is deeper than life. Now, to be happy in a marriage, it's not something that just happens automatically. A beautiful and happy marriage is created day by day. It's the little things that become the big things. Remembering to say, I love you. Never being too old to hold hands. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It's having a mutual sense of values and objectives. It's forming a circle of love that gathers in the entire family. And it's doing things for one another, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. And finally, as we all know, it's standing side by side and hand facing the world together. It's not about expecting perfection in one another. On the contrary, it's about cultivating flexibility and patience and understanding and a very good sense of humor. And if you know these two at all, you know they have that part down. They have it nailed. Now, we know they have become each other's best friend, confidant, listener, teacher, and critic. And I want you both to know, I've been married 35 years, and all of these things are going to continue to deepen in your marriage, especially the critic part. Do you hear that, Ernie? No, I am totally kidding, Shawna. You know that. You know, most of us find it interesting to learn how couples meet. People meet in many ways. And what is it that brings couples together when they meet and it's magic? Is it serendipity, a happy accident? Fate? God's plan? Well, whatever you choose to believe that it is, even fate or God's plan sometimes needs a little push. And in the case of Shawna and Ernie, that push came from Ernie's mom, Dee, who is sitting here beaming in the front row. And interestingly enough now, you're already laughing. You know this goes back a while in time, but we aren't going to really talk years. Let's just say I think Bill Clinton was president. And at that time, as circumstances would have it, Shawna worked in the same office as Dee. Well, one day she happened to be talking to Ernie, and she told him, you know, come to think of it, there's a young lady in this office I think you should meet. Well, Ernie filed it away, you know, and didn't necessarily think a lot about it, until one day, a little while later, he happened to go into the office and see his mom, and he looked across the room, and he was really kind of taken aback. There was Shawna, and he said to her, who is that? And he said, that's who I've been telling you about. That's Shawna. Well, they did hit it off right away and got to know each other. And they dated for a year, they told me. And they liked each other very much. But let's just say the stars really weren't aligned for these two kindred spirits at that time. And they parted. Now, little did either of them dream at this point of heartbreak and breaking up that over two decades later, they would reconnect and would find that in spite of all the years, the chemistry and the connection was still there. Now, perhaps more meaningful because they both had grown up a bit, right? Matured. And, well, an innovation that Ernie really appreciated. Thank the Lord for Facebook. Right, Ernie? Now, the truth is, he told me he never really got over Shawna. And so one day he found her on Facebook, you know, just, you know, how we do on Facebook, look around, see how people are doing. And when he reached out to Shawna, she was shocked, you know, like, oh, Lord, but in a good way. No, in a good way. So Ernie reached out. You see, sometimes when you least expect it, is when life sneak up and do something wonderful in our lives. And that is exactly what happened here. They told me they were so nervous at their first meeting, they really could hardly think straight. Ernie said his heart was about to jump out of his chest. made even more intense when she came walking through the door, and she was more beautiful than before. He was really shell-shocked. Shawna said Ernie's presence stopped her cold, and it did take her breath away. And she said, I knew I was in big trouble here. I just, you know. But it turned out to be one of those evenings where time sort of stood still, and then describing it to me almost like sounded like a movie, and it happened to be New Year's Eve, right? And they talked for a long time, and I think they both realized that the new year was going to be an extraordinary one. And it wasn't long after this, getting reacquainted and starting to date and get to know each other again, that it hit them both that this is a friendship that held the promise of much more than just a passing acquaintance this time. And they've sort of been together ever since. And let's just put it this way, Ernie was not going to let her get away this time. Well, needless to say, it was very important that Kaylin was on board with this. And she took to Ernie and vice versa. And this is indeed a blessing. Ernie told me Shawna has the biggest heart of anyone. She puts everyone else first. And she's selfless. Shawna told me that Ernie makes me feel so special and safe. And he is our rock. And we do have fun too. So here they stand this evening before us now, making plans as they conclude their courtship, about to beginning a journey together as husband and wife that will lead them into the rest of their lives. Today, you're about to pledge your love and care for each other in marriage, which binds you closer than any spoken or written words. As I said, marriage is a promise. It's a potential. And today it's made in the hearts of Shawna and Ernie, who love each other very much and takes an entire lifetime to fulfill. Would you join me in this prayer for them? Let us pray. Dear Lord, we have joined together in hearts and minds to honor the most sacred of God's wishes that we now unite Shawna and Ernie in marriage. Help it always to cherish the day their friendship took on new meaning, that has deepened into the strong love that's grown between them. Work that love into all practical things so that nothing can divide them. Give them words kind and loving and hearts always ready to ask for forgiveness as well as to forgive. And soon we will place this marriage into your hands for faith and patience, hope and love, and in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours. Amen. And now I would like Shawna's good friend, Heather Jones, to come up. And I have this right here. Thank you. And she has prepared a special reading for us.
I still have to use my glasses anyway. Sorry, y'all. Okay, so from beginning... No, oh, sorry. I'm all nervous.
Okay. Okay.
I know. Sorry. I just love you guys so much. Okay. From Beginning to End by Robert Fulghum. You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you have been making promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held riding in a car or over a meal or during long walks. All those sentences that began with, when we're married, and continued with, I will, and you will, and we will. Those late night, thank you, talks that included someday, and somehow, and maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things are the real process of a wedding. The vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things we've promised and hoped and dreamed. Well, I meant it all, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher. For you have learned much from one another in these last few years. Now as you say your vows, you cross the threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, This is my husband. This is my wife. And now your vows are, and now your vows are about to be exchanged. And as you exchange them, you cross the threshold of life where things will never quite be the same again. For after your vows, you will be able to say, this is my husband, and this is my wife.
So Ernie and Shawna, you ready for this? Ernie, do you take Shawna as your wife, joining with her today, offering your friendship, unconditional love, to share in all of life's experiences, and be a part of one another's dreams and goals? Do you promise to honor her growth and her freedom as well as your own, to cherish and respect her, love and protect her in times of challenges as well as times of joy?
I do.
And Shawna, do you take her in and joining with him today as your husband, offering your friendship, unconditional love, to share in all of those dreams and experiences and be a part of one another's future? Will you honor his growth and his freedom as well as your own, to cherish and respect him, love and protect him in times of challenges as well as times of joy?
I absolutely do.
We're indeed honored, and it's my pleasure that Shawna and Ernie have prepared their own vows, and the lucky groom gets to go first.
You're mic'd. So.
I am mic'd. Thank you. Shawna, 25 years ago, I always knew you were the one that got away. I never stopped thinking about you and had always wondered, what if? I went through life always wondering and finally accepting that perhaps it was just never meant to be. Fast forward 25 years later, and my what if turned into a second chance. After our first reunion dinner, there was no doubt in my mind, those same feelings of love was still there. And I believe God felt it was time to bring us back together. I remember in that moment how beautiful you looked to me, even more so than when you were 20. I feel so fortunate to share this journey with you. It was always my wish to have a daughter, and I got one in Kaylin. I couldn't be prouder to call her my stepdaughter. You're a wonderful mother that any child would be lucky enough to call you mom. Shawna, you are my best friend and confidant, the partner I know who will support me and be there for me under any circumstance in life. There is still a part of me today that cannot believe that I'm the one who gets to marry you. Each morning when I wake and see you, I feel so in love. And in each evening when I kiss you goodnight, I feel even more in love. You are truly the love of my life. My one and only, and the one I want to grow old with and have that happily ever after life. I promise always to be there for you and Kaylin, to take care of you and to protect you both to the best of my ability. Through hard times and good times, through sickness and health, I'll always be at your side. I promise to be the man that I see now in your eyes, today, tomorrow, and for always. And I will love you for all the days of my life. I love you.
looks like we made it. We're here. Okay, I have to see. My dearest Ernie, as I stand here together with you on our wedding day, my heart is overflowing with love for you. I couldn't wait to walk down the aisle to you today. When we met over 25 years ago, I didn't know it, but I had met my Prince Charming. When you found me again shortly after my father's passing, it seemed from the beginning that you were sent to me for a reason. The timing couldn't have been more perfect. Losing my father has been one of the most difficult things that I have ever been through in my life. And yet, in the midst of having to bury my father, you were there. You appeared from nowhere, swept me off my feet, and instantly became my rock, and you never let go. It was in your love that you lifted me through my grief. You stayed by my side, and you grew to become my person and my very best friend. I wish that my father could have met you, but I have a feeling that he already did, and he actually chose you, that he sent you to be with me and Kaylin so that we would never be alone. I'll never forget the first time that you told me that you loved me. It was in that moment that I realized that you had become the one person in my life that would understand me so deeply, who would see me so completely and love me so passionately. The way you love me is unlike any other love that I have ever known. With you, I feel so safe and accepted and appreciated. But most of all, loved. You truly see me for who I am, and for the first time, I can genuinely be myself. You love me at my best and at my worst. You love and care for Kaylin as if she were your own. Who couldn't ask for anyone better than that? Even with all our curling irons and our clothes and our whatcha who's it's and whatnots and everything we bring into your museum, and you love us. Oh my goodness. You have moved us into your heart and made a huge space there. And we love you for that. From this day forward, I promise to give you the best of myself and ask of you no more than you give to me. I promise to respect you as your own person and grow alongside of you. To forever love you when our love is simple, and when it is an effort. I will share in your dreams and support you as you strive to achieve your goals. I will listen to you with compassion and speak to you with understanding. I promise to open my heart and give my deepest love to you every single day. I vow to take care of you in heartache, and celebrate with you in joy. I promise to fight for you and never let go. I will choose you over myself without pause. I will love you from this day until the very last breath. I promise to bring all of these things to you. Together, we will leave this world a better place to be in, because the love that we share matters. It matters not just to us, but to each and every person in this place today. I know I have some years to make up for, and maybe the last few have only felt like moments, but now we'll have time. Together forever, me and you, and thank you for finding me. Thank you for loving me, and thank you for being who you are. And thank you for loving Kaylin, and from this day forward, our journey together as husband and wife will be just amazing. I love you.
How about that? May I have the rings, please? Thank you, Henry. Thank you. The wedding rings are the outward invisible signs of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying unto all the uniting of Shawna and Ernie. They also have come to represent an unbroken circle of love, with no beginning and no end, and no giver and no receiver, for each of you are the recipients. So as you're placing the ring on Shauna's finger, you will offer her this second vow, saying,
in token and pledge. In token and pledge. In the vows between us made,
with this ring,
I thee wed,
and pledge to you
my abiding love.
Ernie's ring represents the same outward invisible sign signifying Shauna's love for him. So your turn, as you're placing the ring on Ernie's finger, you will offer him this second vow, saying,
I give you this ring.
Wear it with love and joy.
For I choose you to be my husband this day and every single day.
I accept this ring. I will wear it with love and joy.
For I choose you
to be my wife
this day
and every day.
Shauna and Ernie, you now take into your care and keeping the happiness of the one person in the entire world that you agree to love above all others. You've stood here and agreed to share strength, responsibilities, and to share love. So always be sharers of each other's dreams, consolers of each other's sorrows, and helpers in all of life's challenges. And I know that all of us here want life to be great for you two, that you will build a marriage and family filled with joy and peace, contentment and challenge all of the days of the years allotted to you, and greet each and every morning as a welcome gift. And end each day with a sense of something special and beautiful having transpired between you. And as the years move along, never take each other's love for granted, but always experience that breathless wonder that exclaims, out of this entire world, you chose me. And I know all of our wishes, hopes, and dreams will go with them this day and every day. And now, as you know, not only are two joined in love today, but a new family is formed. And now you will symbolize this joining through the pouring of these individual containers of sand. And as you each hold your sand, the separate containers represent your lives to this moment, individual and unique, and that they will always be. As you blend the sand together as a family, just as the grains can never be separated, of course it is our hope and prayers for you that your marriage and family will be together always. Would you join hands? Good for you. And now the moment we've all been waiting for. Shawna and Ernie, I pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And ladies and gentlemen, I have the distinct pleasure to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ernie and Shawna Paez. There they are. Look at all your people. Yay!
Yeah. first of all, I'd like to introduce to you our maid of honor, Kaylin Vaughn, escorted by best man, Henry Alfaro. Yeah, yeah. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to invite everybody to please stand up for a very special introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the brand new Mr. and Mrs. Ernie Shawna.
I just can't handle it, this thing called love. I must get around to it. I ain't ready. Crazy little thing called love.
Shawna and Ernie, let's hear for him one more time. All right, so they're going to make their way over to their head table. Everyone, let's hear for him one more time. And our first toaster is going to be best man Henry. So let's hear for Henry, everybody.
Welcome. So my name's Henry Alfaro, and I have the honor to be the best man for Ernie. Ernie and I go back a number of years, as you've heard earlier today, and it's an honor and a privilege to be part of the wedding for Ernie and Shawna. Congratulations and best wishes to a wonderful life together. So Ernie, Senior, Dee, and Vicky, you should all be congratulated for the guidance and support that you have provided for Ernie and Shawna to this date. They've turned out to be a perfect couple, and they're a match made in heaven. And Kaylin, it's official. Ernie now is your stepfather. He's a pretty cool guy. He's pretty hip, as you know now. And he's been known to take part in some mani-pedi sessions with the both of you, so I think he'll get along just well. Also, the bagpipes. What's the story here? So, my beautiful wife, Hallie, is of Scottish and Welsh descent. And she thought it would be great to welcome Shawna into our family with the bagpipes as part of the ceremony. So that's the story behind it. And in addition, I'm not sure if everyone knows here in the room, but a year ago in several weeks, Ernie proposed to Shawna at the Inn at Spanish Bay in Monterey. They were at the fire pits, sipping Jack Daniels, and listening to the bagpiper. I don't know if Ernie's aware of this, but many years ago, I proposed to Hallie at the Inn at Spanish Bay. We were on the beach sipping champagne, but similar situation. So, hence the bagpipes and its full closure, and wanted to celebrate with you. So, Ernie and I go back many years, as you're all aware now, and one story I like to talk about is when we were in elementary school, we developed a liking for building forts and developing codes for each other. Remember that, Ernie? So, in fact, a few days ago, I actually found the book that we purchased together called Secret Codes and Ciphers. So we used to write codes to one another, and in elementary school we had a summer camp, and I went first and Ernie went on the second week. So I wrote Ernie a letter in code and hid it in the wall of one of the cabins, hoping Ernie would find it. So the next week, Ernie went, and he was in a panic mode. He was looking, he couldn't find it. So he wrote me a letter from camp. It's postmarked 1975, February. In the letter, I won't read it to you, but in the letter he states that he couldn't find the note I left him in the wall in the code, and he sent me this note. So I have these two items for your memories and your scrapbook of this wedding. So since you never found the letter, Ernie, I spent a few minutes writing you a new letter, okay? Now, I work on Wall Street. I'm in finance. So what you're gonna hear now is what the officiant just heard or said out in the lawn. So I may be in the wrong business. We'll see. February 22nd, 2020. Dear Ernie, well, this day is finally here. Today you start your life journey together with Shawna. When I say journey, it also includes your process to getting to this point in life. Our friendship dates back to preschool, so we have truly experienced many positive and challenging events in life. Upon reflection on our years of friendship and experiences, we have developed a bond unhindered by our physical distance. We went through high school together, all the way through elementary through high school. We celebrated many birthdays together. We took vacations together. The fishing trips are a great memory. We double dated to proms and other formal events. You were my best man, and now I'm here to return your favor. Of course, we also experienced the more challenging parts of life, such as the passing of several beloved family members. They are with us today in spirit to celebrate your and Shawna's special day. Ernie, these are special memories, but more importantly, these experiences in life formed your foundation. You are a man who believes in helping others. You are selfless and are so very dedicated to your friends, family, and loved ones. I am proud to have you as a friend, and I truly believe your fine qualities will enable you and Shawna to experience a life filled with happiness. See, I'm older than you by 6 months, 5 months. I have a few more years of marriage under my belt as well. So because of that, I will always be available to offer you advice and guidance. Marriage is an equal partnership, and there's so much to learn from your spouse. I have learned so much more in life from my beautiful wife, Hallie. I have complete confidence Shawna will have a similar impact on you. Never take marriage for granted. Do not only tell her that you love her, but show her. Listen to what she has to say and learn from her. You are now partners in life. Hold her hand. Show her you are there with her. Kiss her goodnight. Kiss her good morning. You are a team now. Decisions are for the team, and compromises are a must. Really listen to Shawna's words. You will learn so much from listening, and more so about her soul. My parents had a few quotes that I took for granted during my youth, but now I fully understand the depth of the message. My dad frequently told me prior to a long journey, drive defensively. Now I know the underlying message. He wanted me to be careful and take care of my loved ones through the journey in life. My mom sitting over here at this table, continues to tell me, keep on trucking. In other words, never give up, pursue your dreams, and grow with your family. Ernie, I'm very happy for you today. It is quite an event to see you marry the love of your life, Shawna. Hallie and I wish you the both and wish you eternal bliss. Be kind, be gentle, be happy. Drive defensively, Ernie, and keep on trucking. So if we could all raise our glasses. To Ernie and Shawna, reach for the stars and achieve your dreams. God bless your marriage. Best wishes, Shawna. Congratulations, Ernie. Cheers.
Let's hear for Henry, everybody. Best man, Henry.
Trying to stay out of the pictures. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to introduce you and you just keep really close.
Okay.
All right.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, now we're going to turn things over to Maid of Honor, Kaylin Vaughn. Let's hear it for Kaylin, everybody. There you go.
Yeah. I thought you were good. I just want to start off. I'm very nervous. Thank you.
She's amazing, right? Come on. Woo!
Okay. Okay. Good evening. I just wanted to first off say thank you, everyone, for coming. To celebrate the unification of my beautiful parents. These people are my world. I love my mom very much. Ernie, we'll get to you. okay. My mom has truly shaped me to who I am today.
I had to put the phone back on.
Sorry. Let's just say that my mom has been there through everything. I have gone through some very tough times in my life. And it's just who my mom is. My mom has always been there, and it's constantly her. She's a person I go to constantly. Maybe too much sometimes. Okay. The many fights I have with my mom are very fun to deal with, but it's okay. We get through them, right, Mom?
Yeah.
From driving me place to place to many choir things, or literally just Target, to get who knows what. By the way, you can never walk out of Target without one thing between me and my mom. She will always be there in a heartbeat, and Mom, I thank you for that. Our story has its ups and downs, but mostly we get through it. You are my world, and our story started off in a little shoebox, which I had been very young, living in a small apartment down in Cyprus. We got around for the most part. We got around, my grandpa at the time had gotten very sick for a couple years. He suffered from liver cancer. It was a very hard time. My mom literally dropped everything, her job, to take care of. Him as he as his very last day. And that day was very special because we got to say goodbye. Ernie, a couple weeks after my grandpa had passed, had texted my mom off of Facebook. And I noticed something had changed in my mom. My mom was very different, and it wasn't a bad different, it wasn't anything, but I noticed she was happy. And I kept bugging my mom. I was like, "Mom, what, like, tell me who this is, like, come on, like, I'm sitting here waiting, like, come on, tell me." And she finally did, and I said, I was very happy for my mom, because it had taken a very long time to find who she wanted. Pop that up. Oh, this is really hard. It was a super hard time once my grandpa had passed, just because my grandpa was my everything, the second person I talked to. He is here today, very close. So Ernie, my mom talked about you every single day. Up until I met him. And there's a funny story with that. So I was at my friend's house, and I was like, "Mom, when are you coming to pick me up? Like, Mom, come on, like, this is, you need to pick me up, like, it's time." She's like, "Okay, I'll be there in a little bit, okay. So my friend lives in Temecula, and my mom came and got me, and she's like, "Okay, so we're not going home." And I was like, "Okay, where are we going? Target, store, wherever?" Target. I asked about Target. And she goes, "No, you're going to meet Ernie." And I was like, "Oh, no." I was like, I had a bun in my hair. I was in sweat. I was like, "Are you kidding me? He's going to think I'm a slob. Mom, come on." So we got to the door, and Ernie opens the door, and Ernie did not know I was coming. And I was like, "Hi, I'm Caitlin," like, kind of just there. And it was a very fun night. He took us to dinner, and ever since then, I knew he was the one. I knew after knowing their story and going through it and my mom talking to her, I knew it. I was like, "Mom, I know it." So after they got engaged and they had come home, and I said, and they were acting really weird. I was like, "Okay, guys, like, do you have to tell me something? Because, like, you know with them too. They'll walk in the door and they're like, 'Oh, hey, like, it's okay.'" And I'm like, what are you guys, like, come on, tell me." So it's a funny story. I will tell it really quickly. My mom, the day my mom asked me to be her maid of honor, me and my best friend Savannah were home right before they had come home. And the one day I decided to take out my trash. I take out my trash and I was like, okay, whatever. I take out my trash. My mom comes home and she goes, "Did you take out your trash?" And I was like, "Yeah." And she's like, "Did you see anything?" And I was like, "No, I took out my trash. Like, what are you asking me? Like, are you okay or what's wrong?" She's like, "Never mind." She rushes down the stairs. And Savvy had went home, and I was sitting in my bed. And I was like, "Okay, like, when's my mom coming upstairs? Because I know something's up." And I walked downstairs, my mom had called me downstairs, and there was a balloon, and there was a box with, "Will you be my maid of honor?" But she was like, "The one day you take out your trash." So that's how my mom asked me to be her maid of honor. So we are here today, a year later. It's a very long time, but we got through it. Okay. Whew. I lost my... So, to finish off, I love you, Mom and Ernie, and you are my world, and I'm so happily happy, thank you, to call you my parents, and I love you very much.
And now we're going to turn things over to the proud father of the groom. Let's have a big cheer for Ernie, everybody.
We had our dinner last night, and I broke down. And I told him, I'm not going to do it again tonight. But I already feel it coming on. So anyway, I went to see them get their hair done this morning. I got a little haircut and everything else. And I'm sitting there and I think, you know, I think Shawna's dad should say something about you. And I think, what would he say? I know how much you love them. I know how much you miss him. And right now he's up there with his ears or his eyes full of joyful tears. And I had to write everything down, otherwise I would not remember it. And I says, okay, Tom, that's enough tears, because it started raining. It's tough. If I had a daughter, I mean, what would I say to my daughter? I have a son. I have a wonderful son. But daughters are different. I think he would say, Shawna, I was so grateful to have you, to have such a beautiful and caring daughter, and even more lucky that you have found a man who is truly, who truly deserves you. I am so happy to see that you have found each other again. I am thrilled that you two will spend the rest of your lives together. Your mom and I have been married, 58 years? So I hope you surpass that. You know, marriage is a journey. So your dad used to call you what, little girl? Baby girl, okay. I know we talk about that all the time, right? And he used to, you talk about the oak tree, a big oak tree, and how he used to help different people and everything else. So, you know, if he was going to give you advice, he would say, baby girl, marriage is a journey, so enjoy the ride. Never yell at each other, unless maybe there's a fire. Okay. Now, I don't know how realistic that is. Okay. So respect each other. Take care of each other. And you, this is, anyway, just love each other. Just take care of each other. Listen to each other. Okay, so, because there's nothing more important than having there somebody to support you. Okay, if my lovely wife would come up here with me. I know she doesn't want to do this. She's very bashful.
Yeah, she says she's coming up here.
Okay, she is.
She says she's got her piece to say.
Okay, but, you know, our son, we have a wonderful son. We couldn't ask more from a son. Okay, so, and again, I think your dad would say, baby girl, you did great. He is a good catch. Okay, so Dee and I would have loved to have a daughter. And unfortunately, we just couldn't do it. And guess what? We have two daughters. Kaylin, Shawna, we love you guys. My son, so proud of you. We love you.
Let's give them another big hand, everybody. And now we're going to have a prayer. So we'd like to invite up Mr. Joe Bonafetti, and he's going to give the prayer. Let's give him a big cheer, everybody.
Thank you. First, I want to thank Ernie and Shawna for the honor of doing this. I was going to have a couple of words, and I thought I would be eloquent, but after Ernie's vows, everything kind of shadows that, so there's really no point in going on. Everybody kind of looked and said, who knew he had it in him? D said he's been practicing for 25 years. This is a blessing as well as a prayer. The definition or portion of a definition of a blessing is a favor or gift bestowed by God, thereby bringing happiness. And that's what this blessing is for. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Dear Lord, we ask that you bless this union. We ask that you bless them, keep them safe. Let their love always be full, be front and center in all that they do. We ask that you not only bless this marriage, but bless this new family as they grow together in love. We ask the Holy Spirit to come upon us today so that we feel the love of those that have gone before us. We acknowledge their presence here today as they sit at the banquet with God and celebrate this marriage. We ask that they have a life filled with love, joy, and filled with God's love as well. As we say, bless us, O Lord, in these thy gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let's give him a big cheer. Thank you very much, Joe.
Twice on Sunday, quote you the scripture plan. I'm far from a preacher, but I'm a believer. Cause every single day before I knew your name, I couldn't see your face, but I prayed for you. Every heartbreak trail when all hope failed, I wonder how in hell I prayed for you. I kept my faith like that old
and the way you look tonight. Oh, but you're lovely, with your smile so warm and your cheeks so soft. There is nothing for me but to love you just the way you look tonight.
Thank you. Alive. Tomorrow brings a new day.